The next type of chart is the Japanese candlestick. And this was really first used by a gentleman by the name of Mona Hisa Homa. He was a Japanese rice futures trader back in the 1700s. And we're going to talk about a little bit about how these candlesticks are constructed. They're very similar to the bar chart in that you have a high, a low, an open, and a close. But from a visualization standpoint, the candlestick is going to tell us a story. Okay? So we're going to use days for periods just to keep things simple. So let's say this candlestick is a given day. You have a hollow candle and you have a filled candle. So let's talk about what the differences are. The high of the day, of course, and the low of the day is the same in both types of charts. But if you have a hollow candlestick, this is what's called the real body. If the real body is not filled and it's hollow, that means that the closing price is above the opening price. In the case of a filled candle, where the candle has essentially melted, it is indicating to us that the opening price is above the closing price. So hollow candle, we have the close above the open, and a filled candle, the close below the open. Whether it's up or down on that given day, based on the prior period's close, is irrelevant when it comes to the hollow and the filled construction of the candlestick. This is only to do with the period that we're discussing. Here's a great example of a filled candlestick. In this case, the open was here. This was the high of the day, which intraday went even higher. Close near the lows of the day, but not quite towards the bottom. In this case, it's basically the exact same candlestick, except one's hollow and one's filled. So in this case, it's the opposite. It opened near the lows of the day and went out on the day near the highs. We had a little bit of a spike intraday that it didn't quite reach there on the close, and we had a little bit of a dip below the open. But at the end of the day, we went out near the highs. This is something that we describe as a bullish candlestick. This melted candlestick would be even more bearish. Here's another great example where we have a long shadow. That wick on top of the candlestick is what we call a shadow. The longer it is to the upside, the more the reversal, the more the sellers took control of that specific period. So while this is bullish and this is bearish, I would argue that something like this that reversed this dramatically would be even more bearish. Now we're going to talk about the individual colors of the chart. And I think that this is something that's not explained very often. Here we have green candlesticks and we have red candlesticks. The colors of the candlesticks are determined based on where the price is compared to where it was in the prior period. Okay, so if we're looking at a daily chart and the candlestick is green, that means the closing price for that day was above the previous day's close. It has nothing to do with where it closed based on the open. The color is simply based on where it closes relative to the prior period. Now, remember, we can have hollow red candles just like we can have filled green candles. So in this case, let's look at an example of a red hollow candle. In this case, we have a closing price in the prior day. The opening price is substantially lower. So the stock gaps lower the following day, rallies throughout the entire day to close near the highs. So since it closed above the open, it is a hollow real body, but since it's the close is below the previous day's close, it's going to be red. Here's the opposite. In this case, we have a green filled candle. So on this particular day, the market went out near the highs of the day. And what this candle is suggesting to us is that the following day, the market gapped up to open substantially higher than the previous closed. However, melted throughout the rest of the day to close near the lows. But since it closed still near the lows of the day, but above the prior day's close, it's going to remain green. So let's remember that the color has nothing to do with where it closes based on the open, but where it closes based on the prior close. So there are four types of candlesticks that we're essentially accustomed to seeing: green hollow ones, red hollow ones, green filled ones, and red filled ones. So let's go over this again. If you have a green hollow candle, that means the close is above the opening price and the close is also above the prior close. The red hollow candle, is going to close above the opening price, but below the prior day's close. The green filled candle is going to close below the open, but still above the prior day's close. And the red filled candle is going to close below the open as well as below the prior day's close.